إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الكلام كلام الله جل في العلا، وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. يقول الله تبارك وتعالى في محكم تنزيله: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الذين سبقت لهم منا الحسنى أولئك عنها مبعدون لا يسمعون حسيسها وهم فيما اشتهت أنفسهم خالدون، لا يحزنهم الفزع الأكبر وتتلقاهم الملائكة هذا يومكم الذي كنتم فيه توعدون. يوم نطوي السماء كطي السجل للكتب، كما بدأنا أول خلق نعيده، وعدا علينا إنا كنا فاعلين. ولقد كتبنا في الزبور من بعد الذكر أن الأرض يرثها عبادي الصالحون. As we know, Allah Ta'ala says in his book, talking about the affairs of the day of resurrection, and he says, يا معاشر الإخوة والأخوات, Allah Ta'ala says that the people who will enter paradise, they will not hear the hasis of the hellfire. And we said that the meaning of hasis, that it means a disturbing, horrific noise that the hellfire will cause due to its inhabitants, due to those entering it, as the burning and also the torture and also the fuel of men and stones will enter the hellfire, and it will cause a very horrific, disturbing noise, to the point where you'll find that the least person or the lowest person who will enter paradise will make dua to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala and ask him, when he enters paradise, رَبِّ جَعَلْ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَهَا حِجَابًا حَتَّى لَا أَسْمَعَ حَسِيسَهَا. As we discussed, the least or the lowest of the individual who received the least reward. And we'll talk about how much you would think that he's in the highest levels in paradise, even though he's in the lowest. He will say to Allah, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, O Allah, make between me and the hellfire a hijab, a barrier, so I cannot hear its hasis, meaning the disturbing noise and the horrific noise and the horror and the fright of its mere sounds, so which it will cause to certain people, to the point, like we said, when an individual wants to enter paradise, oh Allah, make between me and it a barrier so I cannot hear its hasis. You'll find that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says when he allows them to enter paradise, he says, وَهُمْ فِي مَشْتَهَتْ أَنفُسُهُمْ خَالِدُونَ. that which their selves, what it desires the most, they will get it and they will receive it eternally in bliss and pleasure forever. Then Allah Ta'ala says in the ayah, لَا يَحْزُنُهُمُ الْفَزَعُ الْأَكْبَرُ, that the major horror and fright will not cause them sadness and grief. You'll find the Ahl ilm from and at the head of them, as we start with, which is the Sahaba. Because عَلَى رَأْسِ الْعُلَمَا هُمُ السَّحَابَ, as we know, at the head of the scholars, they are the companions of the message of Allah. Listen to the tafsir of it. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they will not be grieved, or they will not grieve, nor will they be sad by the major horror and the major fear, the greatest horror, it will not affect them. You'll find that one tafsir means that the mu'mineen at the time of death, the people of Tawheed, the people of Sunnah, the people of Hadith, the people who clung or who stuck to what was correct in this dunya, who stayed upon steadfastness of uprightness as far as in their belief, in their aqidah, in their methodology, in their minhaj, and in their ta'a, in their obedience and uprightness to Allah. He says that one of the meanings of the greatest horror, he says, qila in al murad bidhalika hu al maut, that the first meaning of it, of the greatest horror, is death. When the soul is departing from the body, embarking upon the affairs of the hereafter, leaving off the worldly affairs, leaving off the worldly life, now it's making a transition to the hereafter, where everyone will be in a state of horror and fright when their soul is departing from their body, embarking upon now an eternal matter, an affair that is what? Will be eternal. And everyone will be in a state of horror and fright when the soul is departing from the body, embarking upon the hereafter, embarking upon something which will be eternal and be everlasting, and it will never stop. They say that's one of the meanings of al-faz'ul akbar. That is one of the meanings of the greatest horror, the greatest fear. Then they say that another meaning of it, of the meaning, of another meaning or another tafsir of the ayah, meaning the greatest horror, is an-nafkhatu fis-sur. كما نعرف يا معاشر الإخوة أن النفخات على ثلاث, نفخة الفزع ونفخة الصع ونفخة البعث. As we know that the meaning of when Allah will command that the angel blow in the horn, that one of the blows will be called نفخة الفزع. As they say, this is another meaning of the tafsir of the ayah, نفخة الفزع. That one of the meanings of it is when the day of resurrection and the day of recompense is about to commence, that there will be a trumpet, there will be a horn and a sound that will be now be heard all through the seven heavens and the seven earths, and it will cause a severe fright to everyone. For those who are living, they will now hear what they call nafkhatul faza. When the horn is blown, it will cause a severe fright and horror in everyone. Then it will be a second horn, which is nafkhatul what? Nafkhatu sa'q, which is now will render one to be dead, render them unconscious, and they will be dead. Then the third horn will be blown, and then everyone will what? Come up from their graves resurrected. They say that this is the meaning of the greatest horror and the greatest fright. The third meaning of it, he says, and I want everyone to think about this predicament. When the day of resurrection, when the servant now, I want everyone to put themselves in this state, put themselves in this predicament, put themselves in this circumstance. They say that the third meaning of the greatest horror and the greatest fright, حِينَ مَا يُؤْمَرُ الْعَبْدُ إِلَى النَّارِ يُعْتَبَرُ مِنَ الْفَزْعِ الْأَكْبَرِ. He says likewise that the meaning of the greatest horror, the greatest fright, he says when everyone will now be standing in front of Allah, and Allah will say to the servant, carry him to the hellfire. That is the greatest horror, the greatest fright. Everyone put themselves in that position. Everyone put themselves in that circumstance when we meet our Lord Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Now everything that we have done up from now, all the way up to the day of resurrection. And when Allah says, may Allah protect all of us from this horror, which is to be said, to be called out, carry him to the hellfire. Carry him to the hellfire is the greatest horror and the greatest fright that any human being will hear in his ears, that now you're going to embark upon the wrath of Allah and his curse and his punishment, tabaraka wa ta'ala. He says that the mu'mineen, as-salafiyin, ahl al-hadith, ahl al-athar, ahl al-ta'a, ahl al-istiqama, la yahzunuhumu al-faz'u al-akbar, wa tatalaqahumu al-malaika, hadha yawmukum alladhi kuntum fihi tu'adun. As he said that the people of Tawheed, the people who learned it, the people who implemented it, the people who actualized it, and their statements and actions, the people of Hadith, the people of Sunnah, the people of Athar, the people of Minhaj al-Salafi, the people of uprightness, the people of obedience, they will not be saddened or grieving by any of these horrors and frights in which we just mentioned in the ayah. Another meaning of the ayah, Ya Ma'ash al-Ikhwa, it's Ahl al-Tafsir that they say that the meaning is, Hina tutbaqu an-nar ala ahliha. He says when the hellfire, and I want everyone to think about this, that the hellfire, Ya Ma'ash al-Ikhwa, to give an understanding, even though there's no comparison to the affairs of this world, to the affairs of the hereafter. He says that the meaning of the greatest horror, and I want everyone to think about this, when you take a pot and you now light the fire under it and you boil it and then you seal it closed, how much intensified the heat and the temperature becomes until it starts to boil inside. The hellfire likewise in the hereafter will be similar to that. The hellfire will now, as some of the ulama tafsir, that they say the greatest in horror and fright. It says when the people or the inhabitants of the hellfire will see that the hellfire will be shut and sealed upon them. Hina tutbaqu an-nar ala ahliha, when it is closed shut upon them, and they will lose all hope of now coming out of it. Hina ma tutbaqu an-nar ala ahliha, that ya ma'ash al-ikhwa, that the inhabitants of hell, they will be sealed inside of it, never coming out from those who died in a state of kufr, in a state of nifaq. And likewise, like we said, however, some of those who died from Ahl al-Qibla, they can, like we said, Ya Ma'ash al-Ikhwa, if they died upon sins that they did not make proper tawbah before meeting Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, that they will be under the will of Allah. Either Allah will forgive them or Allah will punish them and purify them in the hellfire and take them out of it. But however, no one wants to be under the wrath of Allah a split second. Another meaning of the ayah, Ya Ma'ash al-Ikhwa, that the meaning of the greatest horror and the greatest fright, they say that the meaning of it is, as we know what comes in the sahih, what comes in the authentic narration of the Prophet ﷺ, that once the people or the inhabitants of hell enter it, and the inhabitants of paradise enter it, that Allah ta'ala will cause death to come in the shape of a kebsh. فَإِنَّ الْمَوْتِ يَتَمَثَّلُ فِي صُورَةِ الْكَبْشِ وَعِنْدَ ذَلِكَ تُذْبَحُ وَيُذْبَحُ الْمَوْتِ بَيْنَ الْجَنَّةِ وَالنَّارِ فَيُقَالُ لِأَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ يَا أَهْلَ الْجَنَّةِ حَيَاةٌ لَا الْمَوْتِ وَيَا أَهْلَ النَّارِ حَيَاةٌ أَبَدِيَّةٌ سَرْمَدِيَّةٌ لَا الْمَوْتِ. Like we know, likewise, Allah will cause death to come in the middle of paradise and hell. And the inhabitants of hell will see death come in the shape of this animal. And likewise, the people of paradise will see it. And it will be a caller that will call out. And they will say, O people of the hellfire, there will be everlasting life for you, nor death anymore. And likewise, the inhabitants of hell, O inhabitants of paradise, everlasting life for you, there will be no more death. And we ask Allah to keep us firm upon what is upright and what is correct. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له الملك الحق المبين وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله سيد ولد آدم أجمعين صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين وسلم تسليما كثيرا على مر الأيام والليالي والشهود والسنين أما بعد الله تبارك وتعالى continues in his glorious book to go on and say جل شأنه يوم نطوي السماء كطي السجل للكتب كما بدأنا أول خلق نعيده وعدا علينا إنا كنا فاعلين. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says in his book, on a day that we will roll up the heavens, we will roll it up, كطي السجل للكتب, just as a sheet of paper is folded up from its scrolls of what has been recorded. Just like a sheet of paper, and you'll find in the Sahihain, Allah, the Prophet ﷺ described how the heavens and the earth, the seven heavens, السماوات السبع وكذلك الأرضون السبع كلها تطوى ثم تجعل في يمينه تبارك وتعالى كمحبة خردل. You'll find that it says in the Sahihain that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will roll up the seven heavens of how vast it is and how spacious it is and how great it is in regards to what we perceive to be great. And Allah will also fold up the seven earths, because we know likewise which comes in the Sahih that there are also seven earths. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will roll it up and he will make it in his right hand of what we understand of what will be now considered small for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will make the seven heavens and the seven earths in his right hand. Just as one of you will understand of how small a mustard seed is in his hand, even though there's no resemblance with the creation and with the affairs of the hereafter, and especially from the affairs of the unseen in regards to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. You'll find ya ma'ash al-ikhwa, the Prophet Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says in this ayah that those who will be saved, who are those and their characteristics? Then Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala starts to mention who they are. And those who will receive salvation in this world and in the hereafter. وَلَقَدْ كَتَبْنَا فِي الزَّبُورِ مِنْ بَعْتِ الذِّكْرِ أَنَّ الْأَضَّ يَرِثُهَا عِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحُونَ, that Allah has written down and he has now preordained and destined for those who, ya ma'ashal ikhwa, he has written for those who remain firm, steadfast upon uprightness and what is tawheed and the monotheism of Allah, means steadfast upon knowledge and also being around its people. Not being around its people due to some type of what worldly affair, or I'm around individuals because of some money or because what he has, or I'm around individuals because he's from the same background I'm from. That you're around certain individuals because he traverses the same path, the same aqidah, the same belief that you're upon. Because this would gather us, and based upon that, we divide likewise. For ya ma'ash al-ikhwa, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who will truly inherit the earth are Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala ibadihi as-salihun, that his righteous followers will inherit the earth, however, with certain conditions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that in another ayah. Wa'ada Allahu alladhina amanu minkum wa'amilu as-salihat layastakhlifannahum fil ard كما استخلف الذين من قبلهم ولا يمكنن لهم الدين الذي ترضى لهم ولا يبدلنهم من بعد خوفهم امنا. ايش الشرط؟ ايش الشروط؟ يعبدونني لا يشركون بي شيئا ومن كفر بعد ذلك فقد ضل سواء السبيل. Do you find that Allah Ta'ala says in his book that Allah has promised the people of Tawheed, the people of Iman, the people of Sunnah. He has promised them, the people of uprightness. وَعَدُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ That he will make you successors in the earth, just as he made those before you successors. And he will also establish for you the religion and what he's pleased with, tabaraka wa ta'ala. And he will also replace after your fear, security and tranquility. Then Allah mentions conditions and prerequisites for that. He says, يَعْبُدُونَنِي لَا يُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا إِشُ الشُّرُوطِ حَتَّى يَتَحَقَّقْ هَذَا الْأَمْرِ يَعْبُدُونَنِي لَا يُشْرِكُونَ بِي شَيْئًا What is the primary condition? What is it that will actualize and make this affair materialize and be a reality? That you unify me in my worship alone, and that you stay far away from polytheism. For ya ma'ash al-ikhwa, we know ya ma'ash al-ikhwa, the hadith of the Messenger of Allah. And I did not forget from last week. I'm talking about now the hadith of the lowest or the least level of person in paradise. And I'll start by this hadith first. For ya ma'ash al-ikhwa, listen to this hadith. On the authority of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, يجمع الله الأولين والآخرين لميقات أو لميقات يوم معلوم قياما 40 سنة شاخصة أبصارهم إلى السماء ينتظرون فصل القضاء قال وينزل الله عز وجل في ظلل من الغمام من العرش إلى الكرسي ثم ينادي مناد أيها الناس ألم ترضوا من ربكم الذي خلقكم ورزقكم وأمركم أن تعبدوه ولا تشركوا به شيئا أن يولى كل أناس منكم ما كانوا يعبدون ويتولون ويعبدون في الدنيا أليس ذلك عدلا من ربكم قالوا بلى يا معاش الإخوة This puts everything in perspective to let you know who's calling to the truth, who's calling to the correct dawah, who's correctly traversing upon the right methodology. Because Ahlus Sunnah follows the path of how the day of resurrection is going to play out. That Allah will gather the first, the people who came first in this world, then he will also gather the last. He says to an appointed time, meaning the day of resurrection, they will be standing the length of time, which is 40 years. All their eyes will be staring in fright and horror, looking to the heavens, waiting for now, fasl qada, waiting for the recompense now to commence. And the reckoning to commence, Allah will descend in the shadow of the clouds, from the arsh to the kursi, above the arsh to the kursi to the footstool. Then there will be a caller that will call out. Keep in mind the three categories of tawheed again, that you'll find that every Salafi who's truly Salafi, not impersonating Salafiyah, Allah Ta'ala says in his book, listen, he says there will be a caller that will call out, oh people, isn't it not pleasing that your Lord, the one who created you, the one who sustained you, the one who commanded you to unify him in his worship, not to set up any partners with him in the least, that everyone take on as a wali, take on as wala wal bara, every person that what he used to take as a wali and what he used to worship in this world, isn't that justified? Justified from your Lord. They will say, of course, Allah will call out in the day of resurrection. And I want everyone to understand this. Every person that's truly Salafi, truly Ahl Hadith, they are following exactly how the day of resurrection plays out. Allah is going to call out and he's going to say, أَلَمْ تَرْضَوْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ أَلَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَرَزَقَكُمْ وَأَمَرَكُمْ أَنْ تَعْبُدُوهُ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا Allah will start the day of resurrection off by Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. Inaugurating the affairs of Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. will be tested on the day of resurrection. Every person that's Salafi starts their dawah off with that call. Why? Because this is how the day of resurrection is going to play out. Exactly how we're saying it right now. Clear as the sun in the sky. For you find any Muslim starting you off with siyasat kafira, tariqatun fashila, khati'a, mukhalifa, li shar'illah, wa li minhajin nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فإذا خالفت منهج الأنبياء فإن هذه الدعوة فاشلة مخفقة وستفشل هذه الدعوة ولو بعد حين. For any da'wah, like you said, you'll find that Salafiyun starting their da'wah off, we're talking about the affairs of Rububiyah, because Allah has clearly said on the day of resurrection, every person will be put to test by this category. That's the reason why we start our da'wah off with this affair. You see that we teach the affairs of Usulul Thalatha, the affairs of Tawheed, the affairs of Aqeedah, because that's the first affair that will be examined on the day of resurrection. The people's belief system. Allah made these affairs clear for anyone to understand. It does not take anyone with any type of what? Any complication in their understanding to understand exactly what we're saying. There is no obscurity in what we're saying. And there's no obscurity in the da'wah we're calling to, because it's the da'wah of Allah and it's da'wah of all the prophets and messengers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says on the day of resurrection that they will be tested by Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this book, خَلَقًا وَرَزَقَكُمْ وَأَمَرَكُمْ أَن تَعْبُدُوا. That just now, because you know, if you truly have cleansed the affair of Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, we know that it necessitates uluhiyah. And Allah says it in the hadith, in the authentic hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. He says that once now it will be examined, the second affair. He says that now because you know he created you, sustained you, and he now commanded you to unify him in his worship. The second category, Tawheed. Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah. All of it is going to manifest on the day of resurrection. And you'll find that people, Ahl al-Hadith, Ahl al-Tawheed, Ahl al-Minhaj al-Salafi, wa Ahl al-Haq, yabda'un bihadhi al-usus, wa la ya'dalun anha, tarfat aynin, liyannahum ya'rifun, tamam al-ma'rifa, in a'radu an hadhi al-usus, fa inna da'watahum satakun fashila, fi al-dunya wal-akhira, wa la yatawarratun, في ورطات السياسات الكافرة لأن هذه الدعوة وهذا النداء فاشل كما نرى الآن في جميع أنحاء العالم كل مسلم تدخل في هذه الشؤون فنرى أن الله تبارك وتعالى قد أنزل عليهم الذل والصغار والامتهان امتهنهم الله تبارك وتعالى بسبب إعراضهم عن دعوة الأنبياء والرسل فيا معاش الإخوة. You'll find that Allah says he's made it clear. Tawheed al-Rububiyyah will be tested. Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah will be tested. If that's the case, that these will be the affairs that will be asked firstly and examined on the day of resurrection, don't you think that's the first affairs that we should start with when we're in this world? Simple question. Or do you think that we should be starting with politics? Or starting with some other call that we need to now aid the organ donors. We need to talk about how, Yahi, it's permissible to now donate my organs. Yahi, what's that going to benefit if a man dies in his grave or a woman dies in his grave? And the first thing he's going to ask about is the affairs of his belief. مَنْ رَبُّكْ مَنْ رَبُّكْ وَمَا دِينُكُ مَنْ نَبِيُّكْ كُلَّ هَذِي الْأُمُورِ مُتَعَلِقَةٌ بِالْعَقِيدَةِ. What is now donating your organs now? And all is about family members and purifying the issues. Women got issues with men. Men got issues with women. Oh, I'm just so depressed. Yeah, Ikhwa. What is the benefits of all these things about women now enlightening and raising people above their status if they die and they go to hell? What is it truly benefiting all these other calls? What is it going to benefit? Allah and His Messenger have made these affairs clear. the first thing you're going to be talking and be held accountable for as soon as you put under the dirt is affairs that's pertaining to your belief system. That's why the people of Hadith and the people of Sunnah focus on that. And that's how you're able to distinguish from a call that's false from a call that is what? From a call that's true. Then Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says on then the message of Allah says in his last part that he says now, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, that every person that they go towards what they used to worship in this dunya, isn't that just from your Lord? That every person and everyone, they will go towards what they used to worship and what they used to make wala, loyalty for and worship for in this world, and they will come. وَيُمَثَّلَ لَهُمْ أَشْبَاهُ مَا كَانُوا يَعْبُدُونَ. Then it will be put in images and in type of what? Pictures of what they used to worship. Meaning the sun, the moon, the stars, the idols, the rocks. And it will also be given as an image. مَنْ كَانَ يَعْبُدُ عِيسَى شَيْطَانُ عِيسَى وَعُزَيْرُ وَيُمَثَّلُ لِعُزَيْرِ شَيْطَان عُزَيْرِ. And those who used to worship Jesus, Allah will allow to come on the day of resurrection, a satanic shaitan, a shaitan will be in the image of Jesus and mislead them to hell. Then Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will succumb to the mu'mineen. Focus on this. He says, then Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says, or what the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, فَيَتَمَثَّلُ الرَّبْ تَبَرِكَ وَتَعَالَى فَيَأْتِيهِمْ فَيَقُولُ مَا لَكُمْ لَا تَنْطَلِقُونَ مَا لَكُمْ لَا تَنْطَلِقُونَ كَمَنْ طَلَقَ النَّاسِ فَيَقُولُونَ إِنَّ لَنَا إِلَهًا مَا رَأَيْنَا فَيَقُولُ هَلْ تَعْرِفُونَهُ إِنْ رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَيَقُولُونَ إِنَّ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَهُ عَلَامَةٌ فَيَا مَعَشَرَ الْإِخْوَةِ. الله تبارك وتعالى will come on a day of resurrection testing them. And the closest image of what they thought was a law, a test. You know who the people who are answered correctly will be? The people who sat in classes and learned Tawheed, Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, wal-Uluhiyyah, wal-Asma' wa-Sifat. Allah will come to them and test them. And they will say, we seek refuge in you. We do not set up partners with our Lord. And he will say, I'm your Lord. It's a test. The message of Allah made it clear. Some people will now fail and they will flip. They will fail the test. Then Allah talks about the sign. That if they was to see, would you know him, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala? He says, Inna lana ilahin ma ra'aynahu ba'd fayaqul hal تعرف هل هناك علامة إذا رأيتموها تعرفونه إذا رأيتموها. That there's a sign from him. If he was to see you, you will know him. If that sign was to manifest, that sign, يا معاش الإخوة, will be the shin of Allah, which is the third category of Tawheed, Tawheed al-Asma wa-Sifat. But that's not the point why I'm mentioning this hadith. The point mentioned in this hadith is in the end, where I'll stop right here. Where the man who will be now the least and the lowest of those who receive the reward with Allah will be in the circumstances it says in the end of the hadith is this. There will be a man that will be what? Crossing over the bridge over hell, and he will only be given his light. Because we know on the day of resurrection, there will be different levels of light in which the mu'mineen will be given. According to what? According to their aqidah, and according to their righteous actions, and according to how much they stayed away from what? Impermissible actions. And those who answered the correct call and hastened towards answering in this dunya, they will be given a huge light on the day of resurrection. Because, ya ma'ash al-ikhwa, there will be a point on the day of resurrection where everything will become very black. Absolute blackness on the day of resurrection. The only way that one will see is his light he will be given. Depending on the light in which the Prophet ﷺ mentioned that says, the light in which people will be given, some of them will be crossing very fast, very expeditiously, very, very like a shooting star. Some of them from what? Some of them like the what? Blowing of a wind. Until the last and the least and the lowest level will be someone who will be given his light on his toe. And it will be said to him, cross the bridge over hell. And we know the bridge over hell, ya ma'ashal ikhwa. Kahad ahaddu bisay, ahaddu min asayf. Dahdatu mazilla. That we know that the bridge over hell is sharper than the sword. And it's very slippery. May there be said to that individual, cross. Cross. That individual now, as it says in the authentic narration, one individual will now, this man who will be given his light, when it lights up, he will be able to go forward. When it becomes now, when it goes out, he will stop. He can't move. He'll be holding on from one hand, and then another hand will be falling, and one leg will be dragging, and another leg will be falling. Going over the bridge over hell until it says in the narration, he will be afflicted with the hellfire. Keep in mind that this is an individual from paradise, the lowest and the least level. And we ask Allah to be with Ta'ala to give us tawfiq to understand these hadith. We'll complete it next week. And we ask Allah to be with Ta'ala to keep us safe from the hellfire and to keep us firm upon استقامة in this world and hereafter يا معاشر الإخوة ونسأله تبارك وتعالى أن يوفقنا وإياكم إلى تعلم العلم النافع والعمل الصالح وأن يرينا الحق حقا ويرزقنا اتباعه ويرينا الباطل باطلا ويرزقنا اجتنابه ويوفقنا وإياكم إلى الثبات على الحق حتى نلقاه تبارك وتعالى إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وسبحانك اللهم وبحمدك وأشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقيم الصلاة.